मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द रिवीजन यूनिट 3 पोएम 3.1 तात्री। एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट दिस पोएम, बट आई विल लाइक टू रिवाइज दिस पोएम फॉर यू सो दैट इट विल बी अ क्लियर इट यू विल गेट अ क्लियर आइडिया अबाउट दिस पोएम। सो इट इज तात्री, हिस्टोरिकल नेम ऑफ अ रीजन इन यूरोप एंड एशिया ड्यूरिंग 13th एंड 14th सेंचुरी। सो this poem is basically is an imaginary poem, a dream, it has dreamy quality as we have already studied about. So the poet of the poet is the poem, the one who has written this poem, his name is Walter Delamere. Walter Delamere was born on April 25th, 1873. He was an English poet, short story writer and novelist. He is probably best remembered for his work for children and for his poem. His works deal with fantasy, death, rare states of mind and emotion, as you've already learned about this poem. Poet. Okay. So, in this poem, the poet imagines himself to be the master of that glorious, wonderful land called Tartary. So, there is a land called Tartary and he imagines himself to be the master of this glorious, wonderful land, the whole land, the everything belongs to him. In this way, he tries to satisfy his unfulfilled desires in real life. So we all have desires and we try to satisfy this in real life. We imagine, we dream, and then we try to satisfy this desires in real life by working hard. The poem is a journey into the realm of imagination. The land of Tartary has been painted as a very far off, charming and idle place. The place is very charming and idle, and the poet wants to praise everything, whatever present in that land, on that land. In this poem, he also mentions the abundance, luxuries and richness of that place. The poem is a description of poet's life into imaginary monarchy. So he has described his life into imaginary. So in this revision chapter, we're going to start with poem Tartary. We'll revise it. If I were lord of Tartary, myself and me alone, my bed should be of ivory, of beaten gold my throne, and in my court should peacocks flaunt, and in my forest tigers haunt, and in my pools great fishes land the fins artful discern. Then first stanza it clearly mentions that the poet presents the picture of an imaginary kingdom. The first stanza, and when you see this clear picture images, the poet is presenting the imaginary. He's in an imaginary life. He's living his imaginary life, and he wants to make this imaginary life into real one. So he has written this poem that the poet presents the picture of an imaginary kingdom. There's an imaginary kingdom called Tartary. It's an imaginary kingdom. Tartary, he considers himself the king of this empire. Tartary is a wonderful land, and it's a kingdom, and he considered himself as an empire, as a king. He says if he were the king of Tartary, he would be its sole king. He will be this only one king. There should be no one else to share this kingdom. He don't want anybody else to share this kingdom. He only wants to be the part of this kingdom. Only he wants to be the part of this kingdom. His bed will be made up of ivory as a precious material. Ivory, it's a precious material, like foot teeth, like it's a teeth of elephant, the teeth of elephant. So he considered himself the king of this empire. He says if he were the king of this Tartary, he would be its sole king. There should be no one else to share this kingdom. His bed would be made up of ivory, elephant's teeth, which are very precious. His throne would be made up of pure gold. The throne, the crown should be made up of pure gold. He will have a spacious there will not be any mixture of base metal in it. He will have a spacious court in which peacocks will move. A court, you know, earlier they used to have their courts where they used to give justification, justice. They used to judge the things, the administration. So they he wants a big court where the peacocks will move here and there. He wants a peacock should move here and there freely. He wants that. Very proudly, his forest will be full of wild animals like tigers and lions. He, in that imaginary land, he has a forest, which he is the owner of this forest, and he wants tigers and lions should flaunt here and there, should move here and there, very proud. They will freely stroll in the forest as its real owners, as they are the real owner of the forest. They should freely move. His kingdom will have pools full of different kinds of fish. His kingdom will have a small pool where he will have a different kinds of fish. Where he wants to have a different kinds of fish. They will slim aslant. They will be very happy. They will slim as land and they will be very happy and freer than any other object. He wants his fishes to be freely move in the pools and they should be very happy. He wants to connect himself with the nature. He is connecting himself to the nature. And he wants to own everything. The tiny fins of this fish will be sloppy towards the sunlight and will shine proudly and happily. So he wants fish should be very happy and they should be very proud of themselves, and he wants everything in his court, in his kingdom with him, and he will be the owner of everything. Stanza 2. If I were Lord of Tartary, trumpets every day to every meal will summon me, and in my courtyard bray, and in my evening lamps will shine yellow as honey, red as wine, while harp and flute and mandolin made music sweet and gay. So this stanza, the poet further imagined himself as the king of Tartary and mentioned his mealtime. So here now, first stanza he has mentioned about the animals, aquatic animals which are present on land, even the throne, even how his bed should be. Here in this second stanza, he talks about his meal time. So when he'll have his meal, he says that if he were the king of Tartary, this will become a ceremonial event. As if he's having meal on his dining table, there will be great trumpeters that will produce heavy and noisy sounds. Trumpeters, a person who plays trumpet, music, and he will be very happy. That if he will eat and they will play a music. You know, you must have seen in restaurant when you are eating, there are musicians who play music. So there will be great trumpeters that will produce heavy and noisy sounds. And this imaginary life is between 13th and 14th century, where king used to have such imaginary life. The king used to use this real luxurious life. In the evening, there will be lamps of different kinds. The light emitted by these lamps will be as yellow as pure honey. Some of the lights will be as red as pure and bitter wine. And during his meal, and even in the evening, the players will play upon harp, pipe, and many other musical devices. All these musical instruments will create sweet and beautiful music. The second stanza deals about the music. While he'll have his meal time, he will like to have some musicians around him. They will play music and he will eat in a very desirable imaginary way.